السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الموحي إلى أوليائه الحق وصلى الله على رسوله وآله الطيبين ودعاتهم المتلقين أطواد الصدق مؤمنين مؤمنات followers of the one who has been appointed by Nass Person of Truth, Haqna Sahib, Assalamu Alaikum Warahmatullahi Wabarakatuh. May you be among the people who hold love and allegiance, walayat, in their hearts for the true guide, the one who is crowned with the appointment of Nass. May you be among those who recognize and acknowledge the predecessor who performs the Nass and the Mansoos, the one who is appointed by Nass. May you thus hold fast to Allah's strong rope and possess true belief. And by holding this true belief, may you remain steadfast on the straight path, Sirat-i-Mustaqim, which will lead you to paradise. In today's Majlis, I will speak about the separation of the Sulaymani faction from Haqq. In the era of Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah, Ridwanullahi alayhi, who was Sulaiman? When did he make his false claim? What were the circumstances that arose within Dawah, due to which people within the Da'i's home and family supported Sulaiman? Our Mawali have done bayan in great detail on the historical events that occurred, and they have provided clear arguments against the claims of the Sulaimani faction. I will speak about this in brief in today's Majlis with Allah Ta'ala's aid and His Wali Imam Zaman's Ta'eed. Allah Subhanahu says in the Quran Majeed, وَقُلِ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. Allah Ta'ala says to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, say, the truth is from your Lord. So let whoever wishes to do so believe, and whoever wishes to do so disbelieve. The deep meaning of this is that the true guide is appointed by Allah's command. The predecessor appoints his successor through Nass appointment by Allah Ta'ala's divine inspiration and direction. Divine inspiration from Allah is Haqq. It is the truth. As the Quran says, قَوْلُهُ الْحَقِّ, Allah's command is the truth. Whoever denies the successor who has been appointed by Nass, or whoever claims that Nass appointment can be changed, then that person has denied Allah's word, which is always true. Meaning that by rejecting Allah's wali, it is as though he has rejected Allah Ta'ala. The Quran says further, فَمَاذَا بَعْدَ الْحَقِّ إِلَّا الضَّلَالِ, what is there after truth except falsehood? Those who oppose the true guide and those who follow the opposers are all people who have strayed from the true path. You have heard in the previous Majlis how Abdul Majid made a false claim of Imamat in Egypt, and how Mawlatuna Hurratul Malika Ridwanullahi Alayha initiated the chain of Da'is by the Imam's command. The chain of Du'at continued in Yemen, one after the other, by Nass, until eventually the seat of Da'wat came to India, Hindustan. The 24th Da'i, Da'il Mutlaq, first of the Indian Da'is, was Sayyidina Yusuf Najmuddin. He appointed a successor, his mazun, Sayyidina Jalal, who saw the Imam in a dream. The Imam said to Sayyidina Jalal in his dream, perform Nass upon the two Dawoods, meaning Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah and Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah. Sayyidina Jalal appointed as his successor Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah, and he, Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah, appointed as his successor Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah in accordance to Sayyidina Jalal's directive, which was the truth. The Imam had shown him the truth. Haqq. And he Da'i acts in accordance with this. When Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah ascended to the throne of Dawat, Sulayman bin Hasan bin Sayyidina Yusuf Nanmuddin. Sulayman was the grandson of Sayyidina Yusuf Nanmuddin. At that time he was in Yemen. Sulayman gave Misaaq, pledged allegiance to Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah at the hand of the Wali, governor in Yemen, Amir Abdullah, just as others pledged the Misaaq at that time. For 3 years, Sulayman did this. Sajda to Sayyidina Dawood and obeyed him. He even wrote letters to Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah, in which he wrote, "I am your servant and you are my maula." Just as the opponent in today's age used to do. He did sajda to Bawaji Sahib for years. We have seen him doing sajda with our own eyes. There are also letters he had written in which he addresses Bawaji Sahib as Maula, and he writes, "I am your servant." Now, let us return to the narrative of Sulaiman. Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah had entrusted two of the ladies in the household who were in his servitude with substantial money of the Dawood treasury for safekeeping. After Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah passed away, Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah asked the two women to return the money they had been given in trust. But they did not want to do so. And they betrayed the Da'i's trust and committed treachery in order to keep the money. Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah's scribe, his name was Muhammad al-Katib, he also committed treachery and stole from the Dawood treasury. Both the women and Muhammad al-Katib got together and devised the plot. They schemed to convince Sulaiman, grandson of Sayyidina Yusuf, to claim to be Da'i, because they said to each other, he was arrogant and greedy for worldly things. So the three planned that if he puts forward a claim to be Da'i, meaning Sulaiman, we will side with him and support him. And then Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah will not be able to take this money from us. So Muhammad al-Katib, the scribe, forged the letter of Nass appointment and sent it to Sulaiman. He also tricked Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah's two sons and involved them in this lie. Now when Sulaiman received this forged letter, he got together with Muhammad al-Makrami in Yemen and revealed his false claim to the public. Together they deceived and led many people away from the Dawood. Similarly in Ahmedabad, Sulaiman's supporters also misled and deceived many people. They also convinced Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah's sons to make a false claim that Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah had entrusted a large amount of money in trust for us to Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah. And Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah is refusing to give us the wealth that rightfully belongs to us. The two sons brought this claim to the ruler of Ahmedabad at that time and enticed him and bribed him to help him by telling him that if you help us with this, we will give you half of the wealth. The ruler at that time supported the Sulaymanis, and the believers had to face great hardship, so much so that Mumineen could not even gather together on important religious occasions. This dissension, fitnat of Dawat enemies grew so powerful that Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah was forced to go into concealment. It is narrated that Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah stayed in concealment for a long period. And during this time, Sayyidina Shaykh Adam Safiuddin served the Da'i and Dawood with great courage and fortitude. Maulana Taya Saifuddin has said that it is because of him, Sayyidina Shaykh Adam, that the Dawat is still alive in Gujarat today. With him, several distinguished dignitaries like Ali bin Muhammad bin Firoz and Aminji bin Jalal endured great difficulties and served Dawat with great valor and sacrifice. Sulayman's claim was false. Syedna Dawood bin Ajabshah had not said anything to him personally regarding the matter of Nass. And Sulayman himself never claimed that Syedna Dawood bin Ajabshah told me that I am his successor. His entire claim rested on the letter forged by Muhammad al-Qatib. It is not surprising when similar circumstances arise today. Humans become devils when greed for power and worldly things overpower them. The true guide, Haqqna Sahib, Sahibul Haqq, speaks truth. And the truth comes from the true guide, not from a second or third person. The predecessor Da'i now places the entire Dawat in charge of his mansoos. The Da'i to be, he places his highest trust in his mansoos, the one he appoints, more than anyone else. Is it logical that if the mansoos is in the same town with him, that he doesn't tell him, you are my successor? Sulayman was earlier in Ahmedabad, in Syedna Dawood bin Ajabshah's era. Yes, if it happens that the mansoos is not in the same town, and then the Da'i who appoints him may send him the message of Nass appointment through another person, another witness, as you heard in the case of Sayyidina Jalal, who was in Ahmedabad when Sayyidina Yusuf Najmuddin passed away in Yemen. But isn't it irrational to believe that if the Da'i has appointed his mansoos and the mansoos is with him, he still does not inform him? And moreover, that the mansoos prostrates in sajda to another person for many long years in front of the Da'i himself, and the Da'i does not say anything to stop him. Maulana Sayyidina Burhanuddin Ridwanullah alayhi himself told Babaji Sahib Maulana Khuzaimah Qutbuddin that he was to succeed him. Told him personally, performed Nass upon him in private, and when he appointed Babaji Sahib to the rank of Mazun in front of the public in his Waaz sermon with great erudition, he indicated his Nass on Babaji Sahib. He said that Khuzaimah Qutbuddin is my brother and my son. In Arabi, son, walad means walad. The meaning of walad here is mansoos. The da'i to be. Sayyidina Burhanuddin said in another of his Waaz sermons that Sayyidina Tahir Saifuddin, who was Maulana Burhanuddin's father, so Maulana Burhanuddin says that Sayyidina Tahir Saifuddin did Nass on me through which he made me his walad, his son. Those who possess esoteric knowledge, who have studied the higher Dawat Kitab, understand this meaning. That is why most of the Dawat scholars and people of intellect and all the sons and daughters of Sayyidina Burhanuddin paid reverential respect to Babaji Sahib at that time and prostrated in sajda to him, just as they would pay respects to Sayyidina Burhanuddin in the time of Sayyidina Tahir Saifuddin. And as you heard before in the bayans, some people lost their sense of reason and change their beliefs for worldly reasons. Contrary to the oath of Misaaq, they began to differentiate between Zahir and Batin, the outward rank and inner reality. Started to claim that Nass can be changed. This itself clearly shows that they are people of falsehood because they hold such blatantly false beliefs. What happened with the Sulaymanis was that after separating from the true Dawat, they kept on moving further and further from the true belief. Until today, they have now become very similar to the Sunnis. The narrative of Sulaiman's revolt, fitnat, is not yet finished. I will do further bayan on this topic in the coming Majlis, inshallah ta'ala. Mumineen, Muminat, we are known as the Dawoodi Bahra community because we believe in and acknowledge the true Da'i Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah. Sayyidi Hassan bin Idris has said that the biggest proof, I repeat this, he says the biggest proof that Sayyidina Dawood bin Qutubshah is the true Da'i is that he was the Mazoon of Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah. And he, Mazoon, said the Nass has been done on him. Yes, there were other witnesses as well. But the biggest proof in establishing his truthfulness was that he was Sayyidina Dawood bin Ajabshah's Mazoon. That is what Sayyidi Hasan bin Idris says. Just as Babaji Sahib was Maulana Burhanuddin Mazoon for 50 years. And it is related about the Mazoon in our kitab that he always speaks the truth. Maulana Taha Saifuddin wrote about Babaji Sahib with his own hand that Khuzaima does waaz with Imam Zaman's Ta'eed. A phrase which he only used otherwise for himself and Maulana Burhanuddin. There are many clear proofs. Those who have eyes can see them. Those who have ears can hear them. Mumineen, always remain thankful to Allah Ta'ala that we are the Dawoodi Bohra community, the ones who have answered the call of the true Da'wah. And always recite the tasbih, Ehdina Sirat al-Mustaqeem, which means Allah Ta'ala guide us on the right path. So that the two-legged devil, the Satan in human form, does not lead anyone astray from the true path. By the hurmat, sanctity of Muhammad, Ali Muhammad and his du'at, and their du'at, may Allah Ta'ala keep you all in prosperity and happiness, in his protection and safety. And may he grant you all of your wishes. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على رسوله سيدنا محمد وآله الطاهرين وسلم تسليما متصلا إلى يوم الدين يا صباح الخميس